Broadcasting from Warsenal Studio B in Chandler, Arizona, this is MayaCast. Welcome to another edition of MayaCast. I'm your host, Tom Shadle.
I'm your host, Kip Barcel.
And this is episode 372 for Friday, June 24th, 2022. Fireteam Feng Shui, part 4. And so we're continuing along, talking about all the new fire teams and all the different sectorial armies. And up today is, we're going to tee off against each other with TAC and Tunguska.
Nice.
So we've got the Tartary Army Corps and the Jurisdictional Command of Tunguska. Bankers. The Russians and the bankers, not to be confused with the Russian bankers.
Exactly.
but yeah, so that's who we're covering today as we go over the different fire teams. So thank you for joining us, and let's get right into it.
Enemy of my enemy is my friend.
If you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles.
Heavy resistor, sir.
Yes. But why are they using such limited weapons?
Now entering the war room. All right, so we begin with the... is this the last of the... Oh, no, we got French left.
They're so, not that different.
I think we've covered all of Ariana. We're going to start with the Tartary Armory Corps. And I did this one because I played Tartary Armory Corps before it was called that. Before it was a sectorial.
That's a thing.
I played Vanilla Ariadne with Russian models. It was all scouts and antipodes and Spetsnaz when they got released and all that fun stuff. So my first question is not Fireteam related.
Mm-hmm.
It's how does the Russian sectorial not have the bear? They don't have the bear.
Oh my gosh.
How do they not have the bear?
That is a Russia. Very sad oversight.
So...
They
moving
gave
on.
Them all the Cosmoflot.
Moving on. Tech has unlimited duos. They can have one Harry's and one Core, so they are a fairly standard sectorial as far as the variety of fire teams that they can have. There are two Core options. You have Line Kazakhs fire teams, and you have Veterans fire teams. Each can also be a Harry's, and the Veteran... fire teams can also be duos.
Nice.
But we'll start with the Line Kazakhs fire teams. You must have one Line Kazakh. And you can have up to two Kazakh doctors, which count as Line Kazakhs. Which is great. You don't break composition if you bring them. Then you may add up to one Frontovik or up to one Beast Hunter FTO. Those two, of course, would break composition, and you would not get your five-man composition bonuses, just your regular five-man bonuses. In the wild cards, you have Colonel Voronin, who counts as a Line Kazakh, and he counts as a veteran, but we're talking about Line Kazakhs, so he counts as he will not disrupt your comp, but the veteran Kazakh will break composition. So again, it's another case of the... the big beefy guy who used to be surrounded by little guys that get up to ballistic skill 16, he'll get up to ballistic skill 14 now with just the plus one for a full five man because he does not count as a Line Kazakh. He will break your composition. But the Line Kazakhs are your cheap line infantry. Like the cheapest one's 9 points. Like cheap. Cheap. Because they are BS-11 and they are armor one and they have one wound. Right? They're wimps. They're your cheap guys. And they have all of your sort of typical loadouts, right? You've got a forward observer or a medic for your specialist. They're whip 13. They're fine. For guns, you have an AP HMG instead of just your standard HMG because we get all the good ammo in Ariadne. So you can have an AP HMG, which is one SWC, which is neat because of the BS-11 instead of a 1.5 that you typically see. Sniper rifle, just a sniper rifle, not multi, not shock, the AP.
It is shock, yeah.
Yeah, the only thing it is shock. Just regular sniper rifle, only half an SWC, 16 points. They do have a missile launcher at the full 1.5 SWC despite the BS-11 and 17 points. And a grenade launcher for... 13 points and a full SWC. So pretty typical. Forward observer, paramedic, machine gun, sniper, grenade launcher. Typical line infantry, yeah? The Kazakh doctor is also whip 13. Remember, he counts as, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he's 13 points, which is two more than the paramedic. However, line Kazakhs are physique 11. So I think it's worth the 2 points to bring the Kazakh doc instead of the paramedic because he keeps composition and he's better at the thing.
Whatever. I would much rather have whip 13 than trying to roll on physique 11s.
Yep.
And it's actually cool that you can take two of them because that is double specialist if you really want to.
If you really want to. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you want the variety of multiple different specialists mm-hmm. for multiple different classifieds. So let's talk about those things you can add on. Wildcard Voronin, probably better as a solo piece. He's already got Sixth Sense all on his own, so he doesn't need the fire team for that benefit. Like maybe you can bring him along to like pile a fire team into close combat to give him the plus burst for his friends with his close combat at 22 and his martial arts level 2.
Mm-hmm.
AP close combat weapon, fine, good. Physique 13. But like he's also got guard and his friends aren't helping him with guard.
Mm-mm.
Right? So. And that's just, I mean, that was stretching to find a reason to take him in. I think if you have one of those defensive sniper and missile ARO type mm-hmm. teams that sits at 4 kick-ass doesn't move, he could definitely hide out as like the fifth man for that.
Mm-hmm. Just to boost them.
Yep, keeps composition, right? I mean, he's only BS-11 himself. He's got either a rifle or a T2 boarding shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
I like the boarding shotgun because hopefully he's not dealing with people until they are right on
top
of
right
him.
Yeah, right up on him.
And if it's, I mean, guard's cool and it's like the same range.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're coming to kill you, they're probably higher than close combat 22.
Yeah.
I almost said 22nd. So yeah, he could be like the fifth man of a defensive team that you don't plan on going anywhere or whatnot. But me...
I do like the guard option if it's somebody that's like mimetism -6.
Mm-hmm.
Because like if they're that's a lot of infiltrators too. If they come up after him, you're like, you know what? I'm just gonna guard you, I'm gonna ignore your mimetism. Yeah. I'm gonna use my I'm getting plus what, 3 5 because it's martial arts level 2.
Mm-hmm.
So at that point he gets the plus 3, so that's pretty cool. But I like your idea. If it's Fort kick ass,
yeah, maybe
put him in there.
Sure.
Because you want him as a lieutenant. Yeah. He's so much better as lieutenant.
He's plus one whip. He brings an extra command token. he brings Strategos level 1. So he brings an extra... Or, like, his order becomes a regular order, which mm-hmm. is great. But yeah, maybe you know, like stick him in. But if you're going to move your fire team around and do stuff, you don't want to put him at risk like that. He's already at risk enough because of his big fat ass. His 55 millimeter base. He just, like, sticks out. It's hard mm-hmm. to find cover.
Yeah.
For him. So then you can add Frontovics. Again, they're going to break composition, right? So at 5 men, instead of getting up to Ballistic Skill 14 on your line Kazakhs, you're down to Ballistic Skill 12. And this guy, he's an upgrade because he's Ballistic Skill 12 instead of 11, which means 13 in a 5 man. But they're like 2 to 3 times the cost
mm-hmm.
of a Lion Kazakh for plus one armor, plus one ballistic skill, but also mimetism -3, which is super nice. But with Lion Kazakhs, I would rather stay comped.
Yeah.
And get the +3. Still, they do offer new weapon options if you want to keep a cheap fire team that's mostly Kazakhs, right? They bring in a heavy rocket launcher.
Mm-hmm.
Into your menu of options, an AP Spitfire. They have T2 rifles. They also have an MSV1 AP sniper, which is the potential exception to my I'd like to stay comped for the cheap Lion Kazakhs
because
mm-hmm. It's only half an SWC. It's 30 points. It ignores your -3s. You know, you can see when you act past smoke, right? Is it worth the BS loss? It depends on who you're playing, right? Mm-hmm. If they don't have a lot of gammo or stuff to deal with, then it's probably better to stay at Ballistic Skill 14 with your Line Kazaks. But he does also, you know, he's got that MSV 1 and then Mimetism minus 3, like sort of a double whammy. I always like those kinds of models. So that's nice. They also bring new specialist options. You can bring an engineer into your group. Mm-hmm. If you're planning on running around with 9-point models to go do objectives in the middle of the field and want to cover all your bases, sure. Add the engineer to your forward observer and your paramedic. And then there's the Vet Kazak as a wild card. Also breaks composition, but at 5 men, he's ballistic skill 14, which is what your Line Kazaks were going to be at if they were totally comped. And he's got mimetism minus 3. And he's armor 4,
mm-hmm.
7 in cover. He's got no wound in cap and shock immune, like one wound plus NWI.
Mm-hmm.
And he's shock immune. Even though he's heavy infantry, he's not hackable. And Vet Kazaks are veteran.
Veteran.
As the name would imply. So are, to be fair, so are the Frontovics. Mm-hmm. Those are all veterans as well.
No isolating you.
Yeah, no isolating, no lost lieutenant, no retreat. They don't care about any of that. They'll maintain their regular orders. And then as part of a fire team, that's great because you don't want to spend in a regular order on a fire team because then mm-hmm. you're out. So they give you orders to spend, which is great. The main one we want to talk about in this Line Kazak link is the AP HMG. It's 1.5 SWC. It's 46 points. But it is a two-wound model at armor 4, right? With mimetism minus mm-hmm. 3. Ballistic skill 13 going up to 14 because of the 5-man non-composition.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's not the terror he used to be at ballistic skill 16, right? But he's still real good. And almost everybody got this same nerf. So in the grand scheme of things, everything's the same. You're on the same level as everyone else, right? Everybody's in the same boat. Yes, but he's not BS 16, but neither are they anymore. Right?
Exactly.
So, you know, it's in the same boat where they took, like, it's expensive to take the expensive guy instead of that cheap out with the fire teams that we had for a few years there.
Mm-hmm.
Vet Kazaks are also whip 14 instead of 13. So, you know, there is a forward observer, there is a paramedic, and they both have a T2 rifle and light flamethrower. And they're 38 or 39 points. Medic's slightly more expensive than the forward observer. I guess because they can potentially bring your guys back up on an 11 or a 12.
Mm-hmm.
But the forward observer is a whip 14 flash pulse to add to your aero battery or, yeah.
It's really interesting that you say that because if you want to stay comped just to get that 14, as soon as you lose one, they go down and get the plus one.
Yeah.
Which is 12, but if you swap out your HMG and your sniper to the Frontovik, nothing changes.
And the Vet Kazak?
So yeah. You have the Vet Kazak. If he goes down, you're down to 4, but you're not comped, but that Frontovik's still a 12, and it's the MSV-1 sniper.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to run like that sniper HMG, I think I'd rather take the mimetism and extra armor.
Yeah.
Because your ballistic skill's the same. That's a good...
Vekasak actually better.
Yeah, that's true.
Right? Because yeah. You're 14, if you're a fully comp Line Kazak, you lose one,
mm-hmm.
you're down to 12.
12, yeah.
The Vekasak goes down to 13, his base.
Yeah. Yeah, especially if you're, like you're saying, you did the front of it and lost your sniper, but your Vekasak's still there. You're like, well, I'm better.
Line Kazaks are 11.
Mm-hmm.
So if they lose one, right, they'll lose... One BS.
Mm-hmm.
If they're fully comped. Wait, are we talking about fully comped or mixed?
Both. Because if they're fully comped and they lose one.
I just got so confused.
They lose one, they still get the plus one, so they go down to 12s.
Right.
Yeah. Which is why the Vet Kazak is still good.
So they go down two, technically, from 14 to 12. Yeah. But if you're mixed, the Vet Kazak goes from 14 to 13.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Okay. I know where we're at now.
Yeah, and then, like I was saying, if you keep the Frontovik sniper instead of the Kazak, it's still a 12, because mm-hmm. he is 12. So it's just, I kind of like the idea of a mixed in tech.
Yeah. So, yeah. So for 108 points and 2 SWC, you could have the veteran Kazakh with APHMG, who's going to be at Burst 5 and Ballistic Skill 14, a Kazakh doctor, 2 line Kazakh forward observers, just for extra specialists. You could save a couple points by not making them forward observers. And then a Frontovik engineer with the light rocket launcher. Because whereas on the Frontovics, the heavy rocket launcher is a full 1.5 SWC, mm-hmm. and I find I want to keep spending those elsewhere. I've already got the HMG in this link. I don't want all my eggs in one basket, right? The light rocket launcher is only half SWC, makes the rest of the list much easier to build, and it still gives you that continuous damage template that's really dangerous to your enemies. And then he's a specialist. He's an engineer
mm-hmm.
with 13 engineer. Burst 3, Ballistic Skill 13, until you lose somebody, right? So that's a cool little profile. Mm-hmm. Bring an extra... Yeah, the MSV sniper's cool, but if you're using it as specialists and like I picture myself moving around with that APHMG, taking on targets, but then moving up to the objective, right? Mm-hmm. If I bring that MSV sniper, that's useful turn one, but then I'm too close. A little too close. But bringing an extra specialist, and he has a light rocket launcher on him, yeah. So you just murder on the way to your objectives, right? Just let them roll. And then your gunfighters that you primarily are using are Mimetism IS-3, Vet Kazakh, Frontovik.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all good. But, like, the cheap way, that ARO Fort Kickass group is only 72 points and 2.5 SWC for 2 line Kazakh snipers at Ballistic Skill 14, right? Because we're going to be fully comped in this link.
Mm-hmm.
A line Kazakh missile launcher, a line Kazakh forward observer, and then a Kazakh doc to bring people back from unconscious. So it's just ARO fun on the cheap. Like, they got to deal with it. Mm-hmm. And yes, those are probably orders you will not have on your first turn. But how many orders of theirs are you going to burn for them to remove that from the equation? All burst to an ARO. It's cool. But a little bit better, as you were just saying, for 86 points. Not that much more. 2.5 SWC. You keep one sniper, right? He's going to be BS-12 now because it's a mixed team. One Frontovik AP sniper with the MSV-1 and the Mimetism -3, right? And then the missile launcher, the forward observer, and the doctor. So it gives you that MSV sniper in case they're like, well, I'll just come at you with smoke.
Mm-hmm.
Well, haha. Or, you know, and like you said, the Frontovik will, you know, you lose somebody, he goes from 13 to 12.
Yeah.
You'll ARO for kick-ass groups.
And MSV1's really good in ARO right now with smoke. Because then they're like, do you want to shoot back? Because now I'm 4 strong, so I get to shoot through it for free.
But yeah, the line Kazakhs are great if you want to take a lot of the toys that Tartary can bring, like your scouts, your spetsnaz, right? Your antipode packs, your strelocks, Vasily,
mm-hmm.
you know. If you want to bring all the cool things, you know, line Kazakh core,
mm-hmm.
keep costs down, good way to go. I don't mind that 108.1 either. Because it's really easy to still get to 15 and take a bunch of those toys, and then that's a really solid... Vet Kazakh APHMG leading it, light mm-hmm. rocket launcher backup, and a bunch of specialists, flavor of the day. You may even find yourself with extra points where you have to upgrade a line Kazakh forward observer to a Frontovik engineer or, you know, something else. But then we move on to the veteran fire teams. Veteran fire teams are veteran Kazakhs and Frontoviks, who in this instance both count as veteran. As does Voronin from the wild card list. Minimum asterisk, maximum 5. So you're putting together a veteran Kazakh fire team or a Frontovik fire team. And you can freely mix and match them to get full composition.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also bring up to 2 112s, who are doctors in fireman's clothes. And they don't count as veterans, so they will break your comp. But they'll save you points! Yeah, these guys do not care about Lost Lieutenant. They don't care about retreat. They don't care about the isolated state. Frontovics in there counting as veteran help keep your costs down over fielding pure heavy infantry vet Kazakhs, but will still maintain your composition. Mm-hmm. It means the whole team will have mimetism minus three, which is great, discounting the 112 who breaks composition. Mm-hmm. The Frontovics do seem a little expensive for how fragile they are. They're paying a premium on that mimetism minus three, right?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, either Frontovics or veteran Kazakhs are required, so when casualties mount, reforming becomes way easier.
Yeah.
That other fire team, like if you're mixing, you got some vet Kazakhs, you got some Frontovics, you got just your bare minimum of line Kazakhs to keep costs down, and then you lose the two line Kazakhs, you can't reform that.
Nope.
Unless you can reform it as a veteran's Harry's or a veteran's Corps, because all that's left are veterans and Frontovics. Mm-hmm. Yay! But yeah, so veteran Kazakh, the boarding shotgun's the cheapest profile, is 36 points. Remember, they're armor 4. They got 1 plus NWI. They're shock immune. And the most expensive is the 46 for that APHMG. Plus, there's a lieutenant option of the same profile. The X-Visor T2 profile is pretty interesting. In a fully comp link, like a veteran's link,
mm-hmm.
he'd be ballistic skill 16. And he from 16 to 32 is at zero range.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Right, so you're getting your plus three from the fire team and can shoot out to 32. It's like not being in a fire team and having an HMG, except this mm-hmm. one does two wounds every time you fill an armor save.
Yeah, that's really good, because even if they're covered, it's like you just said, it's like not being in a fire team.
If you're out to 40, it's only minus three. That's a table.
Mm-hmm.
And so that makes that T2 rifle really long-ranged. X-Visor, amazing. It's damage 13, but again, you take two wounds for each failed save, right? And it's anti-material. Mm-hmm. You know, for, was it tic-tac-toe, where you could shoot the antennas?
Mm-hmm.
It's probably not tic-tac-toe. It's probably the other one with the 9 objectives. Anyway, he's 39 points. Not bad. For the X-Visor T2 and light flamethrower. So 0 to 8. Also covered. I'll just template you. If you take the lieutenant APHMG instead of the regular APHMG, you save half an SWC. And the faction does have chain of command in Vasily Plushenko or the tank hunter. Those are both camo markers. So it doesn't kill you to run an aggressive lieutenant like Voronin and a bunch of friends to get extra burst to close combat in a fire team. Or, yeah, whatever. But yeah, it doesn't kill you because they can be a marker and actually be safer than your actual lieutenant. They're just expensive, is all.
Yeah.
So yeah, veteran Kazakh APHMG, 1.5 SWC, 46 points. Veteran Kazakh forward observer. Again, these are great specialists. They're survivable with the two wounds, with the mimetism minus three and the armor 4. They're also whip 14 instead of 13. So the forward observer is great. He's got a T2 rifle, light flamethrower, whip 14 on the flash pulse, pushing buttons on 14s. He's 38 points. And then, so I'm building a fire team here. I got the APHMG, I got the veteran Kazakh forward observer, right? He's the specialist that will live.
Mm-hmm.
And then three Frontovics. AP Spitfire, little backup gun. It's only one SWC instead of 1.5. 31 points. The engineer with the light rocket launcher and the T2 rifle again, bringing the D charges along. And then a paramedic. So you've got three different specialists to cover a wide variety of classifieds, yeah? Or get a wide variety of potential bonuses depending on the mission.
Mm-hmm.
You got You got three T2 rifles. You got long-range AP. You got mid-range AP. That whole thing, did I not total that up? Oh, man, I got to do math. 46, 38 is 84 is 115, 144. That's 168 points. More than half your army.
I mean, but it is more than half your army.
It is.
Wounds and armor.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 wounds, but the mimetism -3. And to be fair, like, a antipode packs like 27 points.
Yeah.
So you could still take 2. But yeah. Oh, yeah, 3 different specialists, and you're good from 0 to 8. You're good from 8 to 16. You're good from 16 to 24. You're good from 24 to 32. Like, you got the range bands covered. Mm-hmm. You got the objectives covered. You got the murder covered. That's pretty good. Interesting to note, all Frontovics have assault pistols instead of just pistols. So that starts at burst 4. Mm-hmm. You're in a fire team, that's burst 5.
Yeah, that's really nice.
And because this is a fully comp team, you're ballistic skill 15. So, yeah, approach at your own peril. You're like, they have rifles. Let's get within 8. Okay.
No. Brap. Yep.
And then all veteran Kazakhs have heavy pistols. So your burst 2 goes up to 3, which is fine. Your ballistic skill 16, which is great. But then it's damage 14. Shock.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, watch out for your 0 to 8. Silly Ariana is terrible 0 to 8. They don't just have rifles. They're bad.
Yeah, no.
Whoops. Now, you can add a 112. But it breaks your comp. And it's whip 13. Avec Kazakh's physique 12, right? Which is not that different. And then the Frontovik medic. Frontovik medic?
Paramedic, yeah.
Yeah, there is one. Okay. Because I knew the Vet Kazakhs had one, and I was like, oh, I thought Frontovics are only engineers. No. Fixing them on physique 12, right, and keeping comp instead of bringing the doctor to fix them on whip 13. Meh. I'd rather have the +3 ballistic skill at this point. We're already spending the points, right?
Yeah, I agree.
And I'd rather have ballistic skill 16 and use a solo 112. Or a duo 112 or a Harry's 112. We're on to the next fire team. It's the mm-hmm. Dynamo Regiment fire team. 1 to 2 dynamos, one is required, and then 0 to 1 motorized 112s.
Mm-hmm. I like that option much better.
So it's super, it's going to be less dope next season, but this season it is super dope.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, duo or Harry's for the dynamos. Dynamos are bikes. They got 8-4 move. They have smoke grenade launchers, but they don't have grenades that they can throw. No smoke grenades, right? Like a lot of bike riders might. But they do have the grenade launchers. They also have mine dispensers. +3 from 8 to 16. It's got double shot, which, you know, you may shoot 2
mm-hmm.
if you want to. These are arm 1, 1 wound models, but they have dogged. They're impetuous, and they're ballistic skill 12, which is,
you know, that's not so bad.
That's sort of high for mounted models, right? And they are not the cheapest bikers in the game, Coom, but they are, you know, fairly inexpensive. The cheapest one's 15 points. He's got a submachine gun. He's got a Panzerfaust. What?
Yeah, I know, right?
And then there's a forward observer for 18 points and half an SWC, armed with a rifle, flash pulse, and assault pistol. Whip 13 for that flash pulse and for the pushing of buttons. There's also a paramedic for 19 points, half an SWC, boarding shotgun. I hate that SWC on the paramedic.
Mm-hmm.
Forward observer, maybe you could, it's super fast, and he's got an assault pistol, and he's whip 13 with a flash pulse, and I don't, specialist, I don't know. But the paramedic, definitely not. Why are you 0.5 SWC? You have a boarding shotgun.
Yep.
You should not cost SWC. Maybe it's that dynamos are typically not in specialist roles, so they're making you pay for it out of a lore. Like,
mm-hmm.
It would be super rare to have one actually do any work. So
I could see, I mean, that's the only thing that makes sense to me, because a 112 doctor is 18 points.
And zero SWC. Like, yeah. Light shotgun, yeah. Same whip 13, doctor mm-hmm. instead of paramedic.
Don't know why you'd be taking the other one.
BS 11 instead of BS 12, that is not half an SWC. So yeah, Super stupid. And then the expensive guy is one SWC, 24 points, comes with an AP Spitfire that you will have in range immediately on your 8-4 platform. And so crazy. I love the idea of a 57-point, 8-4 moving Harry's fire team sporting a burst 5 AP Spitfire at ballistic skill 12, a burst 4 SMG. Oh, I need shock. Oh, I need AP. Let's choose. Who also comes with a burst 2 Panzerfaust for 15 points. And then a doctor, who's your specialist, for 0 SWC and 18 points. Like, you can get anywhere you need to, hit any target you need to, do your missions. And then in Season 13, oh my God, they can get cover. They have to give up their Impetuous. So they give up their free order. But that allows them to get cover. And they get terrain total. So if there is difficult terrain of any kind, you can move 9-4.
That's nice.
And they have Mimetism minus 3. So if you give up that Impetuous order, you get the minus 3 from cover and the minus 3 from Mimetism. So they're currently worth way more than their actual points because of those season changes. And so I'm going to move 8-4, and I mean, and I don't mind giving up that free Impetuous order to be able to get cover, because negative 6 with Mimetism. What's up, Tag? Not you, Marut, but the rest of you. Here's here's a burst 2 Ballistic Skill 12 Panzerfaust, two of them coming at you, and you've got negative 6 coming back in your arrow. So. And if you kill me, I was 15 points. And you were 85? 105? Right? So that's a good trade risk to take there. And yeah, you don't have to Harry's. I like the extra burst, of course. But like, you can duo a 112 with the SMG Panzerfaust Dynamo. You can even try and launch smokes with no plus 3 range. You have to have one Dynamo, so you can't run around with 2 112s.
Yeah.
But yeah, run around. I mean, 0 SWC, 33 points. Dicks. Oh, my God. Yeah. So really cool for the cheap bikes that are so good this season. Get all the use you can out of them in the next couple of months before it changes. For real. Brings us to our final fire team, Kip. It's much like your Blackjack.
Yes, it is.
Except it's the Ratnik fire team. It can duo, it can Harry's. It's 1 to 3 Ratniks, but it's 2 to 3 Ratniks because it's duo or Harry's. Right. But you need to take at least one Ratnik, and then you can throw in wild cards. The only wild card choices in the entire faction are Vet Kazak and Colonel Voronin. That's it. You're not sticking Vasily Plushenko in anywhere or anything else. Those are the only two. And so, Ratniks. What are Ratniks? They're availability 3. They are the Silhouette 5 heavy infantry. These are hackable, unlike the Vet Kazaks, right? These are Armor 6, a little tougher than a Blackjack. Armor 6, BTS 3, with one wound and then transmutation. So you take a wound, you go into Battle Ravage, where you're Armor 4 with another wound, and then you have Dogged to continue the fight.
Yeah, that's really nice.
If you need to, right? So there's all these little changes in between a Ratnik and a Blackjack that make them, because these are about 12 or 15 points more than a Blackjack.
They are more expensive, yeah.
9 to 12, I guess, points more. And it's like, okay, one of them like is that Dogged, right? Because Blackjacks don't have the Dogged.
They do not.
And one of them is that Armor 6 instead of Armor 5, right? And then it's sort of like the loadouts.
Yeah.
Okay, so Ratnik number 1, which is the second one listed, because we'll get it out of the way and talk about the good one. It's got a heavy rocket launcher plus one burst.
That's really nice.
That's really cool. Burst 3 heavy rocket launcher in the active turn. And then if you are in a
Harry's.
Ratnik Harry's, that's a burst 4 heavy rocket launcher in the active turn, burst 2 in reactive. He's 47 points, 1.5 SWC, heavy pistol, and trench hammer. If you haven't seen the model, then maybe that's a surprise. But if you've seen the model, it ain't. So, yeah, burst 4 heavy rocket launcher in a Harry's. Okay, but yeah, 47 points. You're looking at half your army for a Harry's of Ratniks. These are words that I'm saying in my mouth. For a Harry's of Ratniks.
Harry's of Ratniks.
Dibs on the band name. Harry and the Ratniks. So then there's the other profile, where you've got an AP Spitfire plus one burst. So Spitfire's 4.
Mm-hmm.
Plus one burst is 5.
Mm-hmm.
You're in a Harry's fire team, that's 6.
Yep.
So burst 6, ballistic skill 13, AP Spitfire, and then if you lose the face-to-face, they have to get through armor 9.
Yeah.
In cover. Also, on this chassis, with the burst 6 Spitfire, is a plus one burst Panzerfaust, and a plus one burst Flammenspeer. And... so a Flammenspeer is, it's got the same range as a Panzerfaust. Like, it's good from 16 to 32 inches.
Mm-hmm.
But instead of, like, the AP explosive damage, what, 14 on Panzerfaust?
Mm-hmm.
This one is damage 14 with a circle template and continuous damage. Or it's damage 15 with no template and continuous damage. It's a Firefaust. So you got that. Now, the plus one burst, like, they're just both the Panzerfaust and the Flammenspeer are disposable too. So you're never going to get up to 3 dice.
Yeah, I was like, you're basically
in the Harry's.
You're like, yeah, it's just the same.
Right. But those are real nice to have, especially on the AP Spitfire guy, where his good range ends at 24. Well, now it goes out to 32 for at least 2 shots. Right, before, and that should be plenty to get him into AP Spitfire range. He's 50 points and 1.5 SWC, armed with an AP heavy pistol instead of just a regular heavy pistol. And do you want to take 3 of these things? Kip's like, yes, yes, I do.
It would be nice, and it is cool for the plus one burst if you do lose one of your Haris. Because then you're like, well, still get on my active turn, unload them, which is nice. But I would try 3 of them.
Well, I mean, it's a ballistic skill. I mean, a burst 6 AP Spitfire, right?
Mm-hmm.
DS-13. So it's like 4.5 SWC and 147 points for 2 AP Spitfires plus a heavy rocket launcher. Or it's 117 points. And 3 SWC for 1 AP Spitfire guy,
mm-hmm.
1 heavy rocket launcher guy, and the 20-point non-lieutenant version of Colonel Voronin.
Okay.
That's nice. The way to make it the cheapest is to use that 20-point Voronin and not have him be your lieutenant, and he can sort of tag along and then murder anything that gets close with guard.
Oh, my gosh. That's like his personal bodyguard across the field.
Right?
It's Colonel Voronin and his ragtag bunch of ratniks.
Now, if you do use all 3 ratniks,
mm-hmm.
instead of breaking comp by using Voronin,
mm-hmm.
Or a veteran Kazakh who would also be cheaper than a ratnik,
mm-hmm.
but not really a lot cheaper because they're all expensive. If you do keep it 3 ratnik, like Kip's 3 blackjack list, if you keep it 3 ratnik, you get plus 3 to your discover for a 3-man.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, you're like, well, yeah, okay, cool, whatever. They have deactivator as standard equipment, even though they're not engineers or whatever. And you can't deactivate a mine until you've discovered a mine. Well, now you're whip 13 with plus 3 to discover. And so, it helps mitigate that mimetism of the mine's camo marker.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something you're going to use every time or all the time or even almost never, but it is there. It's in your toolbox. And then the deactivator from 0 to 8 is plus 6, but then you've already set it off.
Yeah,
so what the hell?
It's not even worth it at that point.
And then from 8 to 16, you're plus 3. So like, yeah, discover the mine at plus 3 and then minus 3 because it's got mimetism. And then nuke it between 8 and 16. It's there. It's on there. It's a tool that you have, whether or not you'll use it all the time or not. But like getting back to the cheaper 117 point, that sounds attractive, right? 117 point Voronin plus 2 Ratnik link. Voronin's got sensor. So
because of his little guard dog.
So he could
search.
Yeah. He could reveal all those camos, and then the Ratniks can deactivate mines and things. You know, there's a little combo there.
Because you can censor them out of line of fire where they don't blow up on you.
Exactly. The other thing, like I said, is to add that veteran Kazakh specialist. Well, it doesn't have to be a specialist, but like it would make sense. You
Why
got
not?
Two big gun platforms. Yeah. Maybe take a guy along that can push buttons. Forward Observer at whip 14. He's 38 points. Brings it down to 135 points in 3SWC for this little Harry's fire team. It's certainly going to bring attention from the enemy. Free up the rest of your stuff to do stuff. I mean, with that cheap ARO fire team, which was 72 points I mentioned earlier, so not the MSV one, which was like 89 or whatever, but the 72 points, like that brings you to 207. You got two Ratniks plus the veteran Kazakh specialist. You got your two sniper missile launcher ARO and forward observer fire team for ARO, right? You got almost 100 points left for toys. And like I said,
for antipodes.
two antipode if you add two antipode packs, you're at 261.
Goodness gracious.
You still have 39 points. You have to get a lieutenant, so you're probably looking at like two Armandinos and then two Line Kazakh rifles. One of those two rifles is your lieutenant. And for all they know, they think it's Voronin running around with Ratniks. So you've got like a three-way hide your lieutenant. So yeah, you could do it, and you're at 14 models, 14 slots. You're at more orders than that because of the antipodes. Adding a couple of orders. But, like, you know, that almost maxes you out at the number of orders you can take. So, you know, I think if you drop an Ermandino and then with the extra points left over from that, you can upgrade that one of the snipers to the MSV Frontovic. But, yeah, leftover room for dogs.
That's ridiculous.
So, yeah, definitely something you could play with and still have plenty of points to spend elsewhere. Grab yourself a scout and an Armandino. Oh, wait, you need a lieutenant. It's fine. Yeah, so there's not a lot of options. There's a lot of different ways to put them together and a lot of different things to try. But you've got Line Kazakh fire team, veteran fire team, bike team, and mech team, right? That's all you have to worry about. So real easy, real straightforward. Not as much like swapping in and out as a lot of other sectorials that have a ton of different wild cards they can move in and out. So it's pretty straightforward, but also pretty brutal.
Effective, yeah. Straightforward, but efficient.
TAC. Kip?
Yes.
TAC, so, you're it.
TAC, nice. TAC. All right, so yeah, on to Tunguska. And funny is how Tunguska came up in my mind is a chat about cyber mines. And somebody asked how they worked. And once we went over it and I threw in some rules and I was like, oh my goodness, that's my new favorite trick to do with like dropping mines and then come around the corner.
Because you reset against him instead of dodge.
Yeah. So I was like, what faction has really good infiltrators? Tunguska. That's who. That's it. There's other like profiles out there. Yeah, with cyber mines. But Tunguska has my favorite of the profiles. So I was like, hey.
To finish your, Tunguska. Like, I just want to try and coalesce your initial thought.
Yeah.
Is that you're... You are out of line of fire around the corner of a building.
Yes.
You lay a cyber mine. The cyber mine is now in their line of fire at the end of that order.
Yes.
But you are still out. So they can't react to you. They can't react to the mine. The cyber mine's now in place. Now you can peek around the corner and back. Now they have to ARO. If they choose to fire back, they will eat the cyber mine.
Yes.
If they choose to dodge, they still eat the cyber mine.
Yes.
If they choose to reset, they eat your shots.
Yes.
Because unlike a regular mine that you can dodge,
yeah,
cyber mines are reset. Okay.
So that is really good, and the cyber mines are EM. So you're like, I was like, oh my goodness, that's great. So that's how Tunguska came along. And it's been a while since I really looked at Tunguska. I've always loved them. I love that these, where we're going to start, your first core Haris is a secured Haris. And the thing about the Securitids, I've always liked it, like they have their business suits underneath their armor.
Uh-huh.
And then the rest of the Tunguska army is just beautiful. You know, they have some of the, except for Mary problems. She's got problems.
She's not ugly. She's boring.
Yeah. But, yeah, just like, I love the faction. So I was like, yes, that's where Tunguska came from this evening. So let's start out with the first option here. And here's the funny thing. Unlike TAC, there's a lot of wild cards in Tunguska.
Yes.
There's a lot of wild cards in Tunguska. So starting out with your Securitid fire teams, they can either Haris or Core.
Yep.
Interesting. Can't duo.
No.
They can just Haris or Core. So that's really nice. And this is your standard total duo. Haris 1, Core 1. Mm-hmm. So to be a part, to maintain comp, you have to be a Securitid. And the only other model that counts as one is a wild card, Helena Kovac. So if you want, you're running the standard run of the mill Securitid, and then if you want to add that extra in, you have Helena Kovac.
Are you saying secure a tit?
Secure your tats. How would you pronounce that word? I've always just called them Securitids.
Securitates.
Actually, you're right. If I said Securitates, this immediately got an R rating. So you're Securitate.
It's catching a small bird.
Yeah, no, there you go. Anyways, that's where your jam is, and it's not a bad fire team either, because they're all both skill 12. So it's almost like they're Fusiliers. You do have, you know, your lieutenant option at 13. Your specialist options are either a hacker, which is really nice. I mean, it's nomad, so of course it's going to be a hacker, right? And a paramedic. Your paramedic is 15 points, has a combi rifle, you know, standard issue combi rifle. The hacker, also standard issue combi rifle, and a regular hacking device, only 18 points, half an SWC. But then you get into your big guns, right? Like, what else am I going to put in there? You have the option of multi-sniper.
Yep.
Heavy machine gun.
Mm-hmm. Typical.
And the Feuerbach.
Not typical.
No. I was like, what are you talking about? So Feuerbachs I really like, because they have the same range as an HMG. But when you get outside 32, they go back to zero. So they're really good on both active and reactive turns, shooting long range, especially at angles people aren't going to be thinking about. And they're super cheap. They are, your multi-sniper is 20 points, 1.5 SWC. Your HMG is 21 points, 1 SWC. And the Feuerbach is 22 points, 1 SWC. But I do like me some Feuerbachs, because like I said, after the 32 inches, they go back down to zero range, all the way, you know, out to 48, which is really nice. You can fire them in burst mode, which is armor piercing double action. So armor's really good now. Feuerbachs are even better. Or you can shoot them, which this is typically what you do in ARO, is you shoot them as explosive, especially if you catch somebody out of cover. So it's super interesting choice there with the Securitate, having that Feuerbach in there. I mean, the other really interesting profiles, if you're just filling them out for points, is both are 16 points. You can either do the boarding shotgun or combi rifle for 16 points repeater.
Yeah.
Which, hey, one of your most popular lieutenant choices in Tunguska is an interventor, because they're whip 15, and then they can hang out in the back and hack through your gigantic repeater network.
And BTS 9.
And BTS 9. So if you are using this as a run up the field, aggressive push buttons, you're also carrying around two repeaters with you, which is really unique to just a standard troop. And they're all veteran.
Yes.
So can't be isolated. Ignore all of the bad things with loss of lieutenant and retreat. And really, really dope. Now, the other one that counts as a securitate is Helena Kovach.
Mm-hmm.
X-Visor. Hey, we just talked about this.
Yep.
You're maintaining composition, so you'll get that plus three, which bumps you up to a 15. But now your breaker combi is now zero out to
32 inches.
So yeah, Helena Kovac, breaker combi, really nice. Lots of troops have less BTS than they do armor. Chain Colt for if you get close, and pistol, close combat weapons. 20 points, zero SWC.
And she's a specialist. And she's got sensor.
Yeah, I was like, specialist on top of the X-Visor and has sensor. That's huge. Because you're running up the field. Hey, now we have sensor. You know what else is awesome that Kovach has? Is triangulated fire. And it's much better now that the dodge rolls have changed. Because if you are facing like Phoenix, who's up on his little hill in cover, getting mimetism -6 and cover, which is -9 with a heavy rocket launcher, so it's outranging most of your small guns, you know. You can say, hey, guess what? I'm just going to dodge with the second part of my order to move out to be in line of fire of Phoenix. And then you triangulated fire. The cool thing about triangulated fire, it is an entire order skill. You get to shoot up to the maximum range of your weapon, and you only take a -3. So that is a 12 if you're at full comp. And the fun thing about it is you get all your burst mods. So it's now a burst 4 breaker combi that you're hitting on 12s against Phoenix's 2. And you can outrange him at that point. It's up to your max range.
Mm-hmm.
The heavy rocket launcher is only 32.
Yep.
So you can make Phoenix -6. You're like, how does it feel? How does it feel, Phoenix? So I actually like starting, if you're going to do a core, just go with your securitate. I like taking both specialists because you do have a paramedic in there. Hacker in there can be a toss-up because having a hacker in your fire team, if you're playing another hacker-heavy army, could be a downfall because you move. You're like, what are you going to do? Well, I guess I have to reset. Because you could hack my hacker with a killer hacker out of line of fire, which is a bummer. But I do like the fact of having both, you know, the paramedic and the hacker in there for missions. Now, I would go with heavy machine gun Feuerbach. I do like the multi-sniper. But having the AP and double action is much better than just double action. And it is range 0, so you don't get the plus 3, but you're getting the bump for a full comp. So I like the Feuerbach. I'm a firm believer in the Feuerbach. I think they're very versatile in this. And if you're going to run that, Helena Kovac, hackers secure it that day, paramedics secure it that day, Feuerbach HMG, 96 points.
Nice.
And 2.5 SWC.
If you want a multi-sniper rifle, you have two other options in the faction that are just better. You've got a Grenzer.
Yep.
Who brings MSV1.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have a Spectre who brings mimetism -6.
Yeah. So I like those a lot more. And that's the thing is if you did want to mix and you only wanted to get the plus one to make everybody a 13, you can put the Grenzer in there. For those reasons. Now, I mean, Grenzers are good, and we will get to them later, because, spoiler alert, that's where we're going next. if you did want to, you know, have a more efficient multi-sniper, I would much rather have a Grenzer at 35 points, because they also come with their Armor 3, BTS 6, MSV1, so they see through you, see right through you, but they have marksmanship. So at that point, the mixed fire team doesn't really matter. If you're at full strength, that Grenzer bumps up to a 14, and it has marksmanship. So if you're plus 3, it's a 17.
Yep.
Doesn't matter. What it does affect is all of your other tools in there, like the HMG.
It's got to be why he can never be in a fully comp team.
Exactly why. I do like the fact of Kovach hitting on 12s instead of 9s because of that plus 3 to your comp bonus. So if you're going to use that triangulated fire, it's really good for outranging other guns because you're only negative 3 and you get the burst bonus. 4 dice, 12s, breaker, Conan's BTS. Kind of like that more than dropping a Grenzer in. But the Grenzer's not to be taken lightly because if you face the Bolt Fire team, it hit you on 19s.
I think she hits on 9s regardless.
Why would she hit on 9s regardless?
Because it allows the user to declare a BS attack with one of their BS weapons against a target within line of fire by making a BS minus 3 roll. Here's the key. Ignoring all other mods.
Yeah. But it specifically states like cover, mimetism.
Well, it's an impartial list that ends with an ellipsis. Range, cover, special skills such as mimetism, ..
Oh, that is so dumb. You could make that argument. I can't argue against that.
And then the second bullet point specifically says mods that affect burst are applied normally. So she would be burst 4, but I believe she'd be hitting on 9 regardless because the Fireteam mod of plus 3 ballistic skill is a mod, and it says ignores all other mods.
Hey, that would make sense if they're trying to balance it out. So in that case, if that is the case,
it doesn't matter if she's mixed or not.
Yeah, I would actually rather. Then I would like take out that Feuerbach and put in the Grenzer. Because, like I said, if you've ever faced a the bolt sniper that's marksman, it is nuts. So let's say we do that. Kassam makes a very good point. I didn't even think about that, that all mods are ignored.
Not all negative mods, all mods.
That is a very good point. I mean, you're only at 109. You're only at 109, which isn't bad. And then, I mean, your HMG is hitting on 13s instead of 15s, which is nice. At that point, it's hey, do you want the MSV1 sniper that's really punking everybody else's snipers, plus allowing you to shoot with the Kovach if you're facing a lot of the MSV6 models, especially like 6 steel phalanx, because they're all 13, because like that means Phoenix is coming at you at 7s with 2 dice and you get 4 at 9s, even that's not bad, and that is not bad at all. So I'm liking them. You can take an interventor. So if you do want to drop your Securitate hacker and throw an interventor in there, you can do that. If you are mixing, if you're throwing a Grenzer in there, why not? If you have the points to upgrade. And then you can also take, which counts for composition, I lied to you, Perseus FTO also counts as a Securitate.
Yeah.
And, I mean, Perseus is cool. Especially if you get close. He is, and here's one of my favorite thing I wanted to point out about Perseus. He's the rogue Myrmidon, right?
Yeah.
So he ran away. So gets courage, gets the frenzy, martial arts level 3, gets no wound incapacitation. So it's like a Myrmidon officer. Around the same points too. Mm-hmm. Most of them are like 38. He's 32 or 33, depending on the loadout you take. Has mimetism, -6, and stealth, just like a merm would. Has no wound incapacitation. Mm-hmm. Here's the kicker. Most steel phalanx characters all got upgraded to shock immunity. But Perseus bailed out before his L-host got upgraded. Mm-hmm. So he does not have shock immunity, which I thought was really funny. Which also shows the, the discount in points. Now, that's a pretty cool stat line, especially if you're going to stay comped. Perseus also has a combi, breaker combi on both profiles, plus 1 damage.
Yeah.
14. Which is really good at medium range. It has a nano pulser, smoke grenades, heavy pistol, plus 1 burst. So now it's basically a super strong shock assault pistol at that point when you're linked, because it's 2+1 plus another one and double action close combat weapon. It's either 32 points for regular, and that's the one that you can take in your Securitate. The 33 point is his FTO version 2, which has super jump, but that doesn't count for the Securitate fire teams. So yeah, like mix, cool. But I do like keeping the, like, if you want to use that Feuerbach HMG, can also throw Perseus in there to stay comped. I like that too. So it's like you can't really go wrong, because you're either taking that AP double action Feuerbach at your higher ballistic skill, or you're taking the Grenzer with the marksman, which is almost better. Man, it puts you in a hard place. Like, the Grenzer having marksmanship's really nice. Once it goes down, though, you're still comped with everybody else, as long as there is. So the rest of your team is going to be Blitz Skill 13, which isn't too bad, because your HMG at that point is still shooting pretty good. Mm-hmm. Actually, it stays the same, because it goes from the +1 ballistic skill. Grenzer goes down. Now you're fully comped. So you get the +1 bonus for +1 ballistic skill for the fully comped four man. So your HMG stays the same. So it's really not that bad. And then your other wild card options. This is where it gets really, really fun. We've already talked about Grenzer. You can put the Cyclone.
Mm-hmm.
I always mess that one up. And the Cyclone is that super, one of the super beefy ones. Armor 3, BTS 6, has the X visor, which is really nice. Repeater, 360 visor, climbing plus. But this is like your Spitfire Feuerbach.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it is on a bigger base, because it's mm-hmm. the Silhouette 4.
Yep.
So, same as your Securitate. In ballistic skill, but it's just a little bit more points. So it's like, do you want the armor 3 with X visor on a Feuerbach, but it's already 0, so I don't know. I mean, it's better on the Spitfire profile. They do have pitchers, so if you want to run around and throw even more repeaters out on the field, they would be good at that, but they're just really expensive. But you can hide them in that fire team if you want to. It's really hard for me to want to put them in there, because I've played with other remotes in fire teams. If you're already moving 5 models around, it's really hard to hide those big bases.
Mm-hmm.
It gets really wonky, but you have the option. You also have the Vostoks. And the Vostoks.
-6.
Yeah, or the -6. That is tempting.
And you know what a Mark 12 needs?
+1 damage. So yeah, that one is really tempting, because you turn that, you know, burst 3 Mark 12 into a burst 4 that's now damage 16, and it's mimetism -6. It just gets really that one's hard to, that one I want to find a place to put in there, because it is also a repeater, it is a remote. If you do want to bring an Evo with the, so you can put marksman on it, that's even better. You're bumping it up to a 13, and then in your good range, it's 16s. It's really, with a
-6 coming back.
Yeah, it's really good. So if you're going to be running that mixed team, that one's really hard for me to overlook. You have Raoul Spectre FTO. If you want to run that mixed fire team, and Spectre's not too bad. I think I like him where he's supposed to belong, because he belongs to the Grenzers, which we're going to get to next. And you have Miranda Ashcroft, Sforza, that both count as bounty hunters. Helena Kovac counts as Securitate, and then Wolfgang Amadeus counts as a bounty hunter. Those ones, it's like I'm not really looking at for the Securitate. Like, not, they don't really have a role. You know what I mean? Like, Cyclone, yes. Grenzer, yes. Vostok, yes. Spectre, you can make an argument if you want somebody in there for, like, close combat-y.
Much rather him jump in off the side.
I would much rather him come in off of the side. He's also another one of those mimetism negative six. Has martial arts level 2 with natural born warrior. So it's really good to go after those other close combat-y dudes. Does count as a specialist at whip 13. The fire team option that you can take as a wild card has a multi-rifle. Drop bears, EM close combat weapon, and double action close combat weapon. So you get to choose. Oh, are you BTS 0? I'm going to hit you with the M. Oh, you're BTS 9 because you're an interventor and I came off the side and I'm running. I'm going to shoot. I'm going to hit you with double action and go after your armor. You know what I mean? Yeah. So you do have a toolkit. I just, it's a wild card. Throwing it out there. Like his individual one much better. But moving on to the second of your core options is the... Spetscorp Special Corps fire teams. Now this is your asterisk. So you can either make a fully comped cheer killer fire team or a fully comped Grenzer fire team. You have to have at least one of each. They're both availability 5, so you can get to your max comp bonus. And then you have another option in the Spetscorp, and that is Fiddler on the Roof. It's the FTO option, which has the little sticker of Cheer Killer. So you can add Fiddler in. We've already talked about Fiddler and why we don't like her in fire teams, because the coolest thing about Fiddler is the jackbots. Mm-hmm. Put her in a fire team, can't have jackbots. Does allow you to have an engineer in it with your Cheer Killers. So if you want to go Cheer Killers, they're exactly what their name says. They are geared up and ready to take out what we all like to call cheerleaders. Your order bunkies, your little order pools, your little, you know, your little cheapo dudes that are one wound. They don't have shock immunity because with your cheer killers, they're close combat 19 with martial arts level 1. So they make other people harder to, you know, hit them. They all have super jump, which is nice, and they have dodge plus 3. So physique 12, they dodge on 15s. That's not too bad. But they range from about 13 to 25 points. And you're looking at the cheapest option being a light shotgun, Pulsar, which aren't bad. Shot close combat weapon across the board. Makes sense, right? They're cheer killers. You get your next options, a submachine gun, nanopulsar.
Yeah.
Which I like. Hey, for 1 point more, you can have the same one, but a specialist. So if you're going to want to push buttons, hey, that's your jam. Submachine gun, specialist, 15 points. Super cheap. Your next one that's kind of one of your gunfighters is your AP rifle with a multi-pistol plus 1 burst, which is nice because that's also AP shock. So if you're in close range, and then you have your shock marksman rifle with MSV2. That's 25 points. You're taking at least one, maybe even two, if you're going after that. And then, again, like I said, you can put Fiddler in there.
Well, what's nice is that the Fiddler FTO in Tunguska has super jump to go with the cheer killers, so they can keep up. And it's an engineer, right, with D charges, whereas the cheer killers just have specialist operative.
Yeah, and that's where she kind of fits, is if you do want to take... I mean, she kind of fits the mold, right? She's around 28 points. It is 28 points. And she's immune to shock, has no wound to cap, and immune to crits. So for her price, it's not... And she's whip 14. So for her price, it is not bad. She comes in the contender plus 1 burst.
Meh.
So it's very meh. She's pushing buttons and throwing drop airs. Like, that's her job. That is her job. So it's super fun. I love the models. The models are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, that's a super close unit. That unit is running up the field, hopefully getting cover from white noise from your repeaters or smoke. I don't even know if you have any smoke in here. I didn't even look at that. But they want to get close. They want to get very close to your cheerleaders and killy kill.
Perseus has smoke grenades.
Yes, he does.
Zonautica has smoke grenade launcher.
I was going to say Zonautica does because that's the bike, right?
Yep.
So, and Perseus... Perseus is not the... he's only in
the fire teams. He's not a wild card.
Yeah, he's either a Securitate or he's a Hollow Man, but he is not a wild card.
Nope. But hey, guess what? The super almost one of the best models ever in the game that you're probably taking with the cheap model. Use that to cover their tracks. That's kind of where they're at. And again, you have your wild cards. You can throw a Grenzer in there if you don't want to go comp. Because I mean, at that point, you're just running around trying to get to the back line and killing fools, right? Or killing specialists in the middle of the field. So I like them. I like the models more than I like the profiles, honestly. I just think that, like, putting that compared to even just the Securitate for range bands and lethality across the board for all models, I like the Securitate a lot more. But then you get into Grenzers.
Okay.
And you do have Raoul Spectre, which counts as a Grenzer. Yes, I do like him walking off the board, but it's kind of nice to have that Mimetism -6 guy running around with you. And if you are playing against factions like Steel Phalanx that has very high ballistic skill, I mean, very, very high close combat, having Natural Born Warrior with Martial Arts level 2 on a close combat 22 model that can switch between double action and EM is really good if you're going to be aggressive. But Grenzer's awesome because they all have MSV1. Just got to watch out for Albedo. Got to watch out for White Noise because MSV1 is in their profile. Their armor 3, BTS 6, 1 wound, shock immune. Specialist. Thank goodness. I couldn't get that out. Your specialist option is just the Ford Observer. That is going to be 29 points, but it is NCO.
Yeah.
And it has sensor. So that is not a bad, specialist option. You're coming standard combi rifle has a light flamethrower +1 burst. That's fantastic. So you're throwing 3 templates out on your active turn. Flash pulse at whip 13. So that's pretty standard. Pistol, breaker pistol. So again, you get a choice.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, do you have high BTS or high armor? I'm going for whatever's the lowest. Does have a close combat weapon. You do have a lieutenant option if you want to. It's 28 points. It's the same as the standard Grenzer Discover +3. So if you're playing full comp, that's nice. You get +3 to your Discover and then +3 to your Discover again. Your Discover. I totally missed the missed the first part of that word. But yeah, so +6. That is I don't know if they stack though. I don't think they stack. +3 discover. Anyways, get +3 discover on the
guy. Why not? It's on his profile, and then you get it for being a composition fire team of 3 or higher.
And I was like, man, I should have researched that before it went out.
And then if you're discovering impersonation,
yeah, it's really nice.
You ignore the -6 mod because you have biometric visor.
Yes. So they do. They have biometric visors too. Super scary for Fides. Super scary for the thing that everybody hates.
Jerry Spaculo.
Yep. And those are just your standard, right? So you go forward observer, or you're getting the +3 discover biometric visor combi rifle with all the flamethrowers. Then you get into your big guns. They have the Red Fury option.
Jeff, not Jerry, stupid.
They have the Red Fury option at 1 SWC, +30 points. Upgrade that to a missile launcher for half an SWC. And then you have your multi-sniper options. Now, the multi-sniper options, they're loaded out the same. You know, multi-sniper, pistol, breaker pistol. That's a theme. Everybody has a pistol and breaker pistol. But the marksman is 3 points more. Worth it.
Yeah.
I'm literally only taking the other one if you absolutely cannot shave 3 points off of your list. If you're at 303 and there's nothing you can do about it, okay, I guess I'm not taking marksman, but I'm trying to fit that in every time.
Definitely.
They do get, I mean, those are a little bit more expensive models. So if you are taking your +3, you want your Ford Observer. Red Fury for short range or marksman, and say, hey, I do want to take Raoul Spectre because, hey, he's pretty cool at mimetism negative six. That's 156. 156
what?
Points for that fire team. And it's not a lot of multi-wounds, but everybody has MSV1. You have all your ranges covered. You have a specialist in there. If you are up in Fort Kickass with your sniper, you're not really worried about Speculos too much if you can get that plus three to discover guy there. Really good. a really good option there. Now, again, you can add in those Vostoks or the Cyclone if you wanted to add in extra mimetism. But, oh, man, if I'm going to run, I mean, they're good options. But if I'm with that marksman, it's just really hard to not have the plus three. Because at this point, it's even better than when you had him in the Securitat. Because they're ballistic skill 12, they're now 15, you're hitting on 18s. But hey, if you want to mix... Oh wait, that's the wrong one, sorry. I was just sitting here looking at Raoul Spectre.
13, 14, 17. Grenzers are 13.
They're 13. Comped. I was going to say, they should be 19s.
Fully comped is 16, and then good range on the sniper rifle is 19. So 19s. And ignore cover, ignoring mimetism up to minus 3.
19s to 17s, I mean, it's here nor there. But again, I faced the bolt team with this loadout. These literally are the bolts of Tunguska. So they're the match. So in my mind, I'm really wanting just to stay fully comped on if I'm going to commit Grenzers. To Grenzers, because I've seen how scary bolts can be. And you do have all of the ranges covered. So and that's with Raoul Spectre. If you wanted to knock that down, you can just take another one of the Ford Observers, which is going to be 5 points less. That puts you at 151. Or you can go straight down to 150 and have two of the Discover plus threes. I'd rather have an extra specialist in there.
Yeah.
So drop Raoul, let him drop in. pun intended. And run the two Ford Observers, because that's two NCO models too, plus double sensor. And then the Red Fury multi-sniper, really like that, man. I'm super tempted to try that out. I'm actually more excited to do that. I was all up on Hollow Man when Tunguska came out, because I really like the idea of them. And that's our last core option. it is the Hollow Man fire team. So you do have to have at least one Hollow Man. And this, again, can be a core, can Haris, and can duo. You can also add in, if you don't want to go full comp, Kree's a Borat. And you could have up to two of those in there. You can do the Stemplers on FTO.
But if you do add a Kree's a Borat, you're not going to be fully comp, so you're only going to get plus one ballistic soul, which makes him a 14. But he's got heavy machine gun with plus one burst, which is five, and then he's in fire team, so he's got burst six.
Yeah, the Kree's a Borax where it's at, man. Like, that is almost... I don't know if I do want to go fully comped with a Hollow Man fire team, because I'll take a Ballistic Skill 14 burst six HMG all day.
Yep.
You get the Stemplers on FTO option. That is the Swiss Army knife of remotes. Your sensor, Ford Observer, flash full spot. And then, hey... Perseus FTO 2 counts as a Hollow Man because he's got super jump.
Right.
So if you do want to go full comp on the Hollow Man, you can do it and add Perseus in there, which is really cool. But having the Kreeza being able to join him is just too good. I don't know if being fully comped is worth it. I mean, so your Hollow Man, their armor 4. Two wounds, remote presence, so that's really nice. You have the double unconscious state. In there, you do have a specialist operative option for a specialist and a hacker with hacking device and tin bot firewall negative three, which is really good because they are heavy infantry and they are hackable.
And they're BTS-6 on top of that.
And they are BTS-6, which is really nice. Their long-range weapons are either a missile launcher at 33 points, 1.5 SWC, or the Spitfire at 34 points at 1.5 SWC. All have breaker pistols. which is really nice.
But their long-range weapon is really a Kreeza Borax with six HMG.
And this is why it's hard to want to go full comp, because, yeah, the Kreeza Borax, with the plus one burst, either HMG or Mark 12, let's be real, you're going with the HMG. It is less expensive than the Mark 12 360 visor.
But it is more SWC.
And their mimetism -3. This is fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, you're taking these. And actually, you know what? My optimal fire team I've written down here. Hold on. Let me plug it back in. Is the Hollow Man hacker, because you want a specialist. Why can't I get back to my thing? All I want to do is have some fun. Right? My loadout is the Kreeza Borax HMG, because you want that burst 6. Hollow Man hacker.
Mm-hmm.
Throw in the Grenzer multi-sniper with marksmanship, because that's a wild card. The Stempler's on because of another specialist in there. That's the super fast sensor. And then this is where I'd take the Vostok. it's funny, I already have that written out. It's 184 points.
Yeah, I figure
3.5 SWC.
I figure, like, so my Kreeza is going to do the shooting.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but when we're really far away, it's the Grenzer sniper, and then it's the Kreeza with his burst 6. Like, you had a Vostok, like, it's not going to be doing anything until or unless, like, the Kreeza goes down. Like, at that point, when I've already got two gunfighters that are not cheap, then I look at Yelena Kovacs to put in, because she is the cheapest option at 20 points, and she massively brings down the cost of the whole fire team.
I actually like that option better. I actually agree with you. I would drop, because that saves you 24 points to put elsewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And when I did this, it was really hard to put, after you put two specters in, which are the hackers with the cyber mines.
Oh, yeah.
You don't have a lot left over. So the list was still good that I threw in, but I agree with you. Throwing in the, like, drop the Vostok and put in Yelena Kovacs, having the triangulated fire is really nice as well. But it keeps it cheap, can still do stuff. I'm 100% on board with that change. And I'm trying to get over to the Stemplers because I want to see their points. Yeah, they're 16.
Mm-hmm.
So you have the Stempler at 16. Oh, no, the FTO is the 17 points. So it's 17 points. You throw in Yelena Kovacs, which is the 20 points. And then you have your Grenzer with marksmanship, your Kreeza just mowing people down, and then your your required Hollow Man. So your Hollow Man fire team is just one. And then you just add all of the other really good things in there. You could add more, but it just gets really expensive. And let's be honest, you're taking the Hollow Man fire team to have a burst 6
HMG
Kreeza Borax. You don't have to make that your core either, because you can rock that really awesome Securitate core, and then Hari's, because you still get the burst. You still get the burst 6 HMG.
Yeah.
It's not, you're not bumping it up that one ballistic skill. But you take the Hollow Man. Again, you could take, I like the Hollow Man hacker. It's got the Tinbot -3 for anybody that's going to hack back. And then your Kreeza Borax. And hey, if you want to keep it cheap, you either put the Stemplers on in there. If you don't want the wide base, throw in Yelena Kovacs. So, really good Hari's team there. And honestly, I think that, like, that's going to be a really popular option, is the Hari's. If you want to see people spreading the field and adding all of the other tricks, because it is Tunguska and there's a lot of tricks out there, and there's a really amazing, beautiful bike that's like a transformer that people are going to want to take. And if you are taking, like, those huge multi-wound fire teams, it really cuts in your availability to those. And Spectres. Don't sleep on the Spectres with Cybermind, people. They have mimetism -6, hidden deployment, and they are my new favorite press profile. Hey, with those creases, you can duo them. So if you do want to take two, you can take two. They're still burst five on their own, and they are not bad at all.
Again, you can save cost armor by throwing in Yelena.
Yeah, exactly. But armor five, man, two wounds. Mimetism negative three. It's just so good. It's just so good. And then we get down to our last two, which are really interesting. Bounty hunter fire teams.
Okay.
So again, motorized bounty hunters. Don't really like the idea of them because they're irregular. You have to use command tokens to make it work if you take at least one.
You have mentioned this before.
Like it. So we've already gone through that in Drew's. But the other bounty hunter option is interesting because they're both asterisks. So you got to take at least one. Mm-hmm. You can take up to three bounty hunters. They're super cheap. They get booty reroll, which is really nice. But then there are three wild cards that count as bounty hunters, and that is Miranda Ashcroft.
Yep.
Sforza, FTO. Sure. Mm-hmm. And then Wolfgang Rock Me Amadeus, which, again, we have gone over. If you want to get him in and get into close combat, it's cool. Now, the bounty hunters can only Haris. Or duo,
yeah.
So if you do want like a cheap Haris that might roll something, might roll a multi sniper, or might roll an HMG, they have their purpose. Their biggest. It's a cheap Spitfire at one SWC, with two submachine guns with acrylite cannons. It's super cheap. You might get something good, but that's kind of their role.
You just take three of the submachine gun acrylic canoon
and they just roll,
and then you have three booty rolls and then three re-rolls. Like,
you just hope you get a long range gun, right?
But actually, one of those bounty hunters with submachine gun actually later on in the game turns out to be Sforza. With a viral rifle and adhesive launcher. Surprise, I'm a priest. Yep.
And, it's cool that they have, Sforza, cause I kind of threw the idea of Miranda Ashcroft around, but she's mimetism negative six, which is cool. She's kind of, she's a specialist operative.
You can't roll that on booty.
No, you can't. So it does give you a specialist, but I mean, what you want her to attack with her monofilament close combat weapon, she's not going to auto wound. So I have a hard, I've played around with her. It's just hard.
Poke a tag.
You can go after a tag with it. Mm-hmm. And a lot of those don't, and just not a,
or a Kriza or a Ratnik.
Just not a, what is it? The, Japanese tag that has martial arts that might mess you up. But yeah, the viral is really nice with Sforza. Bounty hunters are bounty hunters. Talked about them a lot. It gives you a really cheap option that you can get some really cool tricks, plus really cool theme, because we have our Mandos. Mm-hmm. I would love to run my Tunguska with like this little Haris of Mandos running around, adding some extra flavor to it. Miranda hunting tags, hunting other people's low level close combat multi wound models. It's just really hard if your Haris is that Kriza Borak. It's going to outshine the bounty hunters, so they do have their purpose, and it is to be a very inexpensive option that you can get a lot of cool things by rerolling, and they're fun. I actually really like playing with bounty hunters.
If you're taking the Hollow Man core with the Kriza Borax and taking a full core, then
perfect.
It's like the opposite of what you were saying, where you want to take the cheaper Securitate core and then a Kriza Harris. Well, if you go, Hollow Man Harris. With a Kriza in it. But if you go full Hollow Man core, then you're looking for a much cheaper Harris, and bounty hunters might be just the ticket.
Yep, you can go 44 points with the Spitfire to guarantee a high profile weapon, or you can just go 36 points and try to roll something. if you don't want them to be specialists, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's a really neat way to get some big guns in there. And then we are going to move on to the really interesting one, which is the help me out with this, Tom. Is that Nyamnik?
Nyamnik.
Nyamnik.
It's very small. Hold on, I have to get close to my computer.
It's a sea anemone. Anemone.
Nyamnik.
Nyamnik. So yeah, what makes them interesting is it's like the characters. So
kinda, yeah.
Yeah, so it's either Haris or Duo. Your listed members, and each one of these is an asterisk. So it's got to contain at least one of these models. It's the Perseus FTO option number 2. So that's a super jump one.
Mm-hmm.
Spectre FTO number 2, the super jump one. Stemplerzond FTO.
Which has super jump.
Super jump one. And Fiddler FTO, which also has super jump. So is I think that maybe the Nyamnik is something with the jumpy jumps. The trampoline. So this is your trampoline corps crew, I mean. But yeah, it's interesting because, I mean.
It means mercenary in Russian.
Okay, there you go. So it's your second. Well, that's why it says mercenary in parentheses. So that is fantastic. But yeah, it's your characters. So Perseus, Spectre, you could throw Fiddler in there if you want, or the Stemplerzond, which is your super fast guy. Interesting Haris though, because you can have like the Perseus plus Spectre for all of Perseus has got his mimetism -6. Raoul Spectre's got his mimetism -6. The Stempler does not have mimetism -6, but it does have sensor. So you could have the Stempler going running up. I mean, with this little Haris, if you want to stay true without adding any of the wild cards in, you got Perseus there for smoke. You have Raoul there for another mimetism, who is also can jump into battle with Perseus if you want to go close combat-y. But can also throw drop bears for you. And then have your Stempler censoring people to try to go kill camouflaged specialists in the field.
So I have a hard time with it because, again, Haris?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we've got that burst 6 Kreeza of Borax.
Mm-hmm.
And then Duo? I mean, sure. I guess... if you're running your Stempler up to go censor a bunch of camo markers and reveal them, might as well drag Perseus along with you so that he's gotten up the field so that he can, you know, because he wants to get in close combat.
Yeah.
So, I mean, kind of. He's also got a +1 damage breaker combi and mimetism -6. So
yeah. He's a really skill good 13.
He's not bad at gunfighting either, but... you know, you get him into his good range. He throws smoke so the Stempler can advance. The Stempler goes up. It sensors a bunch of things and reveals them. And then he can go up. And if they're all mimetism baddies, he doesn't have MSV. So he can go poke them with sticks.
Yep.
Or, you know. So, like, I guess Duo is where the Nyamniks live.
Yeah, because you have total duos.
And again.
So I kind of like that more.
Spectre. Yeah, he's specialist operative. But I don't want him running up the middle with Perseus. I want him sneaking on from the flanks.
Yeah, I agree with you 100%. Haris is a cool option, especially because you can throw in other models like Grenzers or it's funny as hey, Spectre's here, but he's also a wild card as well. I like the duo yeah. option, especially for what you were saying. Hey, what's awesome about having Perseus on the field? Dragging a sensor along.
Well, Spectre FTO 2 is an Nyamnik. Spectre FTO
regular right.
is a wild card that counts as a Grenzer.
That's funny.
So there are subtle differences.
There is subtle differences. But yeah, I do agree with you with the duo.
Yeah.
Like, that's where this kind of shines. Because Perseus is really cool. He's out there throwing smoke. He does have a role. especially if you're running cheer killers with the MSV2, but having like throwing cover out so that your sensor can just get in optimal range to sensor things is really nice. So that's kind of, I agree with Tom. Like that's where it shines. You know, it does have the Haris there, so you could make some teams, but I mean, there are better Haris options that can be cheaper. Like if I'm running, like, hey, I like the bounty hunter option over that if I'm running a full core of Hollow Men with the Kreeza Borak, just to keep things cheap. But hey, this is where Wolfgang can live. Because if you do want to Haris and get a bunch of close combat baddies up the field with smoke, then just put him in instead of Sempler and let Spectre, Perseus, and him just run.
Mm-hmm.
Although, again, throw Spectre out, let him run off the top of the table, keep the Sempler in there so you can sensor your way up as you go in case you need to take stuff out. But hey, Wolfgang and Perseus, match made in heaven right there.
Mm-hmm.
Perseus Amadeus.
Nope.
Amadeus, Perseus Amadeus.
Oh, Wolfgang.
Oh, man. But that's what I got. That's what I got for Tunguska.
Very cool. So if you have been playing TAC or Tunguska and have thoughts that we overlooked or things that you do differently, please let us know and send us an email at tom@myacast.com.
And kip@myacast.com.
Conversation can serve no purpose anymore. Goodbye.
So that's going to wrap up episode 372. Programming note, next week there will be no show because I have a family reunion vacation in Virginia Beach, and so I will not be here to record. Also, MayaCast Masterclass Quarter 2 is coming to an end. The quarter ends at the end of June, and we always have the due date be the Monday, the first Monday of the following month, right? In this case, that would be Monday, July 4th. July 4th is a holiday in America. It's the 4th of July. It's Independence Day. And therefore, you get an extra day, and MayaCast Masterclass submissions will be due on Tuesday, July 5th.
Nice.
Is when I will assemble the gallery. So time is running out. The theme for this quarter is Fireteams.
Feng Shui.
So Fireteams are due on Tuesday, July 5th. There will not be another show to warn you. That show on July 1st is not coming out. We're not recording it. I'm not going to be here. So this is your final warning for Masterclass Quarter 2, Fireteams, due on July 5th. And, enter, because the more we get, the more prizes we give away, and they're all random. So, you know, as long as you enter, you have a chance to win, an equal chance with everybody else. So that's coming up real soon, which means our next show will be July 8th. And on July 8th, that show will not be Fireteam Feng Shui Part 5. It will be the Masterclass talking about all the awesome entries and giving you the new category. So not only will it be a break from all this, but it will also be shorter. So you have that to look forward to. So thank you very much for listening. And until next time, get out there and support your local game stores.
To find out how you can support the show, go to patreon.com/MayaCast.
You can find us online at www.MayaCast.com.
We are on Facebook at facebook.com/InfinityMayaCast.
Follow at MayaPodcast on Twitter.
Join the MayaCast forum group on Facebook.
And as always, you can email us at tom@myacast.com.
And kip@myacast.com.
We'll be right back.